Hello all, my name is Sujin George and welcome to this lecture series of surveying. In today's class, we'll be discussing about the two-peg test. Now, before starting the two-peg test, we need to understand the permanent adjustment of leveling. Now, we have already seen the temporary adjustment of leveling. In that, there are three steps. First is the centering. Second is the leveling, and third is the focusing of the eyepiece and focusing of the object glass. Now, a permanent adjustment of leveling is also there, and in this, the establishment of a desired relationship between the fundamental lines of a leveling instrument is termed as permanent adjustment. Means you have to establish a desired relationship between the fundamental lines of a level. Now, what are the fundamental lines of a level instrument? There are four fundamental lines. One is the line of collimation, that is LOC. Second is the axis of bubble tube. Third is the vertical axis. And fourth is the axis of telescope. These are the four fundamental lines of level. Now, some desired relationships has to be established in order to have the permanent adjustment of leveling. Now, what are these desired relationships? These are the following relationships between these lines. The line of collimation should be parallel to the axis of bubble tube. Means this line of collimation, it should be parallel to the axis of bubble tube. Second is the line of collimation should coincide with the axis of telescope. So, line of collimation will pass through the telescope of the level, and also axis of telescope, it will pass through the center of the telescope. Okay, so both should coincide. Both should coincide. And third relationship is that the axis of bubble tube should be perpendicular to the vertical axis. Means this axis of bubble tube, it should be perpendicular to the vertical axis. Okay. So, it means that the bubble should remain in the central position for all directions of the telescope. Okay. Now, in order to establish these permanent adjustments of level, we need to carry out the two-peg test. The two-peg test or the two-peg method has to be carried out. Now, in order to understand this two-peg method, we'll solve a couple of numericals. Now, this is the first numerical. In a two-peg test, the following readings were taken. This table is given: instrument station, staff reading on A and B, remark. So, instrument station midway A and B, it is these are the readings. And instrument station at A, these are the readings. Okay. So, in remark column, it is given that distance between pegs A and B is 100 meters. So, with the instrument at A, what should be the staff reading at B for the line of collimation to be exactly horizontal? Second, is the line of collimation inclined upwards or downwards? And third, you have to find what is the amount of collimation error. Now, in this, first if we need to make a figure, it is saying that instrument station means the level station, it is midway, this level station, it is midway between A and B. So, one level is here, a staff is here, another staff is here. So, this is point A and this is point B. And suppose this is leveling station at point C. Now, here when it is midway, both these staffs are at equidistant. Both A and B are equidistant from this leveling station C. So, staff reading on A, it comes out to this reading. It comes out to 1.585, and staff reading on B, It is 1.225. Now we don't know whether the reading is inclined upwards or it is inclined downwards. We are just assuming that it might have gone upwards. We will see whether it is correct or not. And it is saying distance between pegs A and B is 100 meters. Means this total distance is 100 meters. Now we will also see whether this 100 meters carry any value or not in solving this numerical. And in second case, this is the first case, you can say the first setup. In the second setup, when the instrument station is near A, so this is the leveling staff and the instrument station is near A, leveling staff at A, this is the leveling staff at A and the instrument station is near A and this is the leveling staff at B. So when the instrument station is at A, the staff reading at A is 1.425. So this staff reading, it comes out to 1.425 and the staff reading at B, it comes out to 1.15. So this staff reading at B, it is 1.15. And let us say that this is point D. This is point D. So first we have to find out with the instrument at A, what should be the staff reading at B for the line of collimation to be exactly horizontal. Now this is the second setup. Now in the first setup, as the instrument is midway between A and B. So we have already seen that it will give the correct difference of level, that is it will give the true difference of level when it is midway between A and B. So true difference of level, in the first setup will be given as 1.585 minus 1.225. And this value comes out to 0.36 meter. In the second setup, we will not get the true difference. We will get the apparent difference. Okay. Now, as the staff, the instrument is near this staff held at point A. So we can say that staff reading at A might be correct because this is very near to A. Okay. So correct staff reading at A in the second setup, correct staff reading at A, it will be equal to 1.425 meter. So correct staff reading at B should be what? Correct staff reading at B should be equal to this value, that is 1.425 minus this true difference of level, that is minus 0.360. So this value, it should come out to 1.065 meter. This should be the correct staff reading at B. But observed staff reading at B is what? This value. So observed staff reading at B is given as 1.15 meter. So what does this indicate? This means that observed reading is this, but correct staff reading should have been below this point. Okay, correct staff reading should have been below this point because this is correct staff reading and it comes out to 1.065 and observed staff reading is 1.15. So as this is observed and this is the correct staff reading, Okay, so observed is higher than the correct reading. Observed reading is higher than the correct reading. So it means that the line of collimation is inclined upwards. Okay, because observed reading, observed is higher than correct reading. Okay, observed value is 1.15 and correct value is 1.065. So observed value is higher than correct value. Hence, line of collimation is inclined upwards. So the second point has been answered. Is the line of collimation inclined upwards or downwards? And first point also has been answered. With the instrument at A, what should be the staff reading at B for the line of collimation to be exactly horizontal? So correct staff reading at B should be 1.065 for the instrument for the line of collimation to be exactly horizontal. And second, third, if we need to find out this amount of collimation error. So amount of collimation error, this will be the observed reading minus the correct reading. And observed value is this 1.15 and correct value is 1.065. So the collimation error, it comes out to 0.085 meter. This is the value of collimation error. Okay, let us solve another problem. Now this problem is most commonly asked. A dumpy level was set up midway between two peg points 100 meter apart. The readings on the staff at the two pegs were 1.650 meter and 1.210 meter respectively. The instrument was then moved by 10 meter ahead of the second peg in line with the two pegs. The respective staff readings were 1.405 meter and 0.935 meter. Calculate the staff readings on the two pegs to provide a horizontal line of sight. Now again, there are two setups over here. We will see the first setup. In the first setup, it is saying a dumpy level was set up midway between two peg points 100 meter apart. So this is the first setup. Now here there is the dumpy level and it is set midway between two peg points 100 meter apart. So let us say this is one peg point and this is the other peg point. This is point A and this is point B and the level is fixed at point C and the distance is 100 meters between the two. Now if you have observed in the previous question, this distance 100 meter had no value. Okay, nowhere it was required. Okay, the data of 100 meter was not required anywhere in the problem. It was just given to mislead us. Okay. Now let us see in this case, is this 100 meter required or it is again of no use. Okay. So a dumpy level was set up midway between two peg points 100 meter apart. The readings on the staff at two pegs were 1.650 and 1.210. So the reading at here, it comes out to 1.65. And at the other staff, it comes out to 1.21. Next, in the second setup, the instrument was then moved by 10 meter ahead of the second peg. This is the second peg, and it was moved 10 meters ahead of the second peg. So, this will be somewhat like this. This is A, leveling staff at A. Here is leveling staff at B. And the instrument was moved, the instrument was then moved by 10 meter ahead of the second peg. So it was moved 10 meter ahead of the second peg. Okay. And the readings the respective staff readings were taken as 1.405 and 0.935. So here the readings that we got, it is at A it is 1.405 and at B it is 0.935. And let us say that this is point B and the distance between A and B is 100 meters and distance between B and D it is 10 meters. It is saying in the problem that the instrument was then moved by 10 meter ahead of the second peg. So it is moved 10 meter ahead of the second peg. This B is the second peg. Okay. So we calculate the staff readings on the two pegs to provide a horizontal line of sight. Now again, here in the first setup, as this instrument is placed midway between A and B, so we will obviously get the true difference of level, between A and B. It will be the higher value minus the lower value, that is 1.65 minus 1.21. This value comes out to 0.44 meter. This value is 0.44 meter. Now, assuming there is no assuming there is no error in line of collimation, while the instrument is at this position D. So, in the second setup, as this is near D, we'll assume that correct staff reading at B is equal to 0.935 meter. As this is near D, we are assuming that correct staff reading at B is 0.935 meter. And also we are assuming no error or zero error in line of collimation. We are assuming zero error in line of collimation. So correct staff reading at B is 0.935 meter as the instrument is near B. So correct staff reading at A, it should be what? It should be equal to 0.935 plus this true difference plus 0.440, and this value it comes out to 1.375 meter. But what is the observed staff reading at A? The observed staff reading at A, it is 1.405 meter. So what does this mean? This shows that the line of collimation is not in adjustment. It is not in adjustment, means it is not exactly horizontal and it is inclined upwards. Okay, the line of collimation is not in adjustment and it is inclined upwards, because here this is the observed reading. Observed reading is higher than the correct reading. The correct reading should be somewhat like this. This should be 1.375. Okay, so as the observed value is higher than the correct value, obviously line of collimation will be inclined upwards. So, in the amount of error, in this 100 meter length, it is given as the amount of collimation error, that is 1.405 minus 1.375. And this value comes out to 0.03 meter. meter. So this amount of error is in this 100 meter. If we need to find out amount of error in this 10 meter. So amount of error in 10 meter distance. So for 100 meter is it is 0.03. So for 10 meter it should be like for 100 meters it is 0.03 the error. So for 10 meters it should be x, and this x is equal to 0.03 into 10 upon 100. Okay, so this x value should be 0.03 into 10 upon 100, and this value comes out to 0.03003 meter. Okay, so amount of error in 10 meter is equal to 0.03 into 10 upon 100, and this value comes out to 0.03003 meter. So this is the amount of error in 10 meters. Hence, we have to apply this amount of error at this staff reading at B. Hence, this correct staff reading at B while the instrument is at D in the second setup. This is second setup. In the second setup, the correct staff reading at B, it should be equal to this value, that is 0.935 minus this amount of error in 10 meters minus 0.003. It comes out to 0.932 meter. And the correct staff reading at A in the second setup will be equal to this value, that is 0.932 plus this true difference of level, that is 0.44 plus 0.440, and it comes out to 1.372 meter. Now if we check the true difference between A and B in the second setup, if we check the true difference of level between A and B, so the staff reading at A, B is this, and staff reading at A is this. So true difference of level in second setup, it will be equal to this 1.372 higher value minus lower value minus 0.932, and this value, it comes out to 0.440 meter. This is similar to this true difference that we obtained in the first setup. Okay, if we get both the true difference same, 0.44 and 0.44, it means that the line of sight has been horizontal, has become horizontal. Okay, so we have calculated the staff readings on the two pegs to provide a horizontal line of sight. So staff reading on the two pegs, it comes out to 1.372 and 0.932. Fine. So this is a very simple numerical on the two peg method or the two peg test. If any doubt arises, you can comment on the chat box. Thank you so much.